Hey, Mike Davenport here, Louisville Chevy Dude. And before I tell you what this video is about, please don't forget to follow me on Facebook and Twitter and subscribe to my YouTube channel. All the links are right below here. So I'm gonna show you three things in the new C7 Corvette today. I've been asked a few questions as far as what the heads-up display looks like, what the driver information center looks like in the MyLink system. The great news is the MyLink system on this car is very, very similar to the Impala and the new 2014 Silverado. So you can check out my videos on how those operate. It's very, very simple to use and is easiest in the industry. So I'm gonna show you the driver information center and the heads-up display mainly in this vehicle. Take a look. All right, so here I am inside the vehicle, and when the vehicle starts up, it's automatically gonna start in touring mode. And you can see that by looking right here, okay? That's gonna be the default setting unless you change that, which I can show you how to do that in a different video. So the driver information center here, I can talk about this car for probably a good 45 minutes to an hour, but that would bore the bejeebers out of you. So I'm just gonna touch on a few different things here, okay? If you look, I'm gonna see if I can get this focused in on here for the heads-up display. You can see the heads-up display there on the windshield. There might be a little bit different way that I can do that, but for this purposes, you can kind of see that in there. You can change the info on it, just like we could in the old one. Different statuses, different way things look, so on and so forth. Let me see if I can zoom in on that a little bit. That might be better. So here's the info on the driver information center heads-up display. So those are all the info tabs. You can still move it up and move it down, and then you have your plus minus. What's really cool is I'm in a manual transmission car, and when I put this, I can put this in gear, and louder in the bottom right, I've got showing me that I'm in first gear. Now here's the really cool thing, manual transmission becomes rev match. So when I put this in rev match, that automatically turns to an orange amber color. Shut it off, turn it on, shut it off. So now you know it's in rev match. You can see rev match on another video that I'm about to do. So back to the driver information center. When you, again, put it in gear, I've got a one down there in the bottom right, tell me which gear. I put the rev match on, I have an amber color. That is how you do rev match. And again, for demonstration purposes, you have the rev match there. This button simply turns it on and turns it off. You can see the one going. The one on the opposite side, same exact thing. Turn it on, turn it off. That's the only thing that these flappers, paddles, whatever you want to call them, do. Turn on, turn off, okay? So back to what this video is intended for is the driver information center. All comes through the steering wheel controls right here. So anytime that you see an arrow, there's an arrow right here, and there also can be an arrow right here. So anytime you see an arrow, that means there's information there. So the left one, you're always gonna see an arrow going on the left side because that brings up your info, brings up the speedometer, stuff like that, Bluetooth, audio, and the settings. So I'm gonna come back out of this info, and you can see that I've got a right one. Now, since I'm on the timer, it's showing the info there. I can reset both, I can start the timer, so on and so forth. So let's say I start this timer, and there we go, it's going, and I'm on touring mode, so it's just gonna show there. But say, boom, I can shut it off and go back over here as well. So I can stop the timer, and then I can reset both, okay? So if I come down, now I have a speed limit. So when I'm driving, it can tell you the speed limit on the street you're on. You have your engine hours and your left time revs. You have your digital speed, you have your trip, average fuel economy, average speed, trip B, average fuel economy, average speed. You can see the average speed's 5 miles an hour on this, so the fuel economy's not gonna be good. There's not very many miles on this car, 10, 12. Fuel range, instant fuel economy, oil life, tire pressures, last 50 miles, which is not gauging because there's not 50 miles on this car. And back to the fuel used and back to, now we'll go back to the speed, okay? So let me change this from touring mode to sport mode. Now, everything changes. Also, the really cool thing about this is when I change it to sport mode, it opens up the baffles on the exhaust. So no more pulling fuses in the seat like we did in the C6. Same thing, come down, You got trip, all that good stuff in here. I'm not gonna go over this stuff. So I'm gonna push it to track mode now. You can see at the bottom, it's telling me track. If I push track mode twice, push the off button twice, that's gonna bring up performance mode. How you want this to do. If you want traction, if you want wet, so on and so forth. So we'll go into that in another video too. So here I'm in track mode. You can see that it all changes. RPM, stuff like that. You can see that go up. I'm gonna push the gas here a little bit. You can see that goes up a little bit. It also changes it on the heads up display too, if I can get that focused in on this. So it goes up there as well. So coming back here, you can link this stuff to change every time you use your mode select button, or you can leave it in a certain area down here. So if I come to preferences on the track mode, I've got different ways of seeing things. See the arrow on the right? Now I can come in here and say I can edit gauges. Say I don't want PSI right there. Say I want to go to G meters. There we go, there's my G force. So I can hit the select button on the mirror and now I can have G force. So actually, let me go back into touring mode, shut that off. You got weather, eco, and then touring. It's gonna change the display, shut the baffles, and now I've got more information on status, G meters, where the G force is located at on the car, accelerate to start 0 to 60 miles per hour, your current. So again, if I want it in touring mode and I'm on a track, start lap timer, I come back, if I hit the select button, boom, I'm at 4.2 seconds on that lap. Say I go around another lap and boom, there's my gain. I gained half of a second. That time I was quicker. I'm just hitting the select button right on the steering wheel and that tells me my lap timer. So come back over, stop lap timer. I can see my lap times as well. Four. So reset timer, comes back. Yeah, oil temperature, oil pressure, battery voltage, transmission fluid temp, and the new cool thing on this, tire temp. There is not a thermometer inside the tires to tell you the tire temp. It's going off all algorithm, tire pressure monitor, so on and so forth. But obviously it's a good thing to know that if the vehicle, you don't want to take these summer only tires out and start performing on them when they're cold. You want the vehicle to tell you that the tires are warm or hot. So it's a nice feature they have. And we're back into status. So come over to, we'll go down to settings here. I'll show you a couple things here. We got US metric, link to drive mode. This is the display theme. So with my mode selector I showed you earlier, if I have that link to drive mode, so I can do that. Say I always want the track mode up. Now I can come in here and say, yep, there's my track mode. That always can come up regardless of what I am. You can see I'm in touring mode. So if I go to sport mode, it's gonna stay the same. My baffles just opened up, and I know you can't hear that on the thing, but it's so cool to do. I go to eco mode and weather mode, it all stays the same. So so that's really nice to do. So speed warning is disabled, features only available in sport theme. It's an open source system, so you're gonna see that come with more apps down the road. Display theme, I can say link to driver mode again and go back. So nav, phone, audio, preference, and info. So so hopefully this is a good insight on some of the things that this car does on that. So let's look at the MyLink radio. Again, it's really, really simple to use, really, really simple to operation on it. I'm gonna try to zoom in here or zoom out here on the whole screen so you can see everything. Everything's touch screen, and then we have not limited your availability, unlike Ford, of not having touch buttons. So you got radio, media, home, you got forward and back, and then you got menu. So I can come in here in the menu and do everything through the menu as I would on the touching the screen. So if you prefer to touch the screen rather than touching the hard buttons, you can do so, or vice versa. So hit this real quick. Say I want to go to my radio, there's my radio. If I want to go to XM, FM, or AM, I simply hit radio again. If I've got USB, I got USB devices open, are in there, which you have one there, and you have two more inside the center console. It shows up there when you hit media. So again, radio goes through your AM, FM, XM. If I hit home, the phone button, the navigation system, your settings, your Pandora. So when you plug in a device that has Pandora that's able to play on it, that opens up. And everything on this is a soft touch. It's a hard touch, slow touch is what I meant to say. So there's your nav. So again, brief description on the vehicle. For your reference, I'm sitting in the car number 35 ever built of the Premier Edition Coupe. So it's a sweet car that I've sold to a friend. But again, if you got questions or anything, please feel free to ask and I'd love to show it to you. And as always, drive safely.